Hello guys, and welcome again to another episode of the Bola Bola Show's take on the UEFA Champions League fantasy football game. So we really thank you so much for all your support that you guys have been giving us, you know, your comments coming in as well. And in fact, more guys are jumping on board our league, and so that's fantastic. Joining the league on the code and the description given there. And you know guys, we really appreciate everything that is happening here, and we'll continue to roll on, you know, in this Champions League fantasy. And hopefully we can able to do more videos of this sort of content, you know, moving forward. Maybe some other interesting stuff we are exploring here at the Bola Bola Show. So, you know, without further ado, let's get into our squad selection, our review of what happened in match day 4 as usual, you know, our squad selection and strategy for match day 5, and how, in fact, the Bola Bola Show Liga is doing. So stay tuned, guys, and jump on board. Hey, guys, and let's have a look at our Bola Bola Show Liga. How's it doing so far? You know, we have got lots of new guys joining in. If you look at the screen here, you see, in fact, we have got a new leader. Goal team, congratulations, and indeed, thanks for joining our league and join in the gold medal place at the moment. So keep it up. Did very well in game week, match day 4 with 100 points there. And then of course we've got also team black and white in 101 points, so 343. These two guys are ahead in the league with 343 points. Fantastic, great, congratulations guys. The league is doing really well here, and you know, these are basically all the other participants in the league. So thank you for joining again. The league code is there. It's never too late to join, guys. Jump on board here. Fantastic stuff here. And we'd like to talk about how did we do in our match day 4. Well, guys, we pressed the limitless button and indeed it exploded. So as you can see here, you know, we have managed to climb up to 12th place, 112 points in match day 4 basically. And if you look at our squad, well, they all came through. I would say those that fell short was KDB. We really expected him to get on fire because limitless was just, you know, the word says it all, right? Unlimited budget, unlimited, basically just go all out. And you only get this chip once. We rolled it in match day 4. It paid off. It could have been better, but we are grateful. And, you know, it brings us back again into this picture. So, you know, Dybala came through, Ronaldo, Lewandowski, Lewandowski. You know, we captained him. Fantastic stuff there. You know, Mahrez did contribute as well, and Cancelo, oh man, this guy is on fire in defense there. It's just that KDB with that 1 point, but overall, you know, we are happy how things worked out for us in match day 4. So means that as we walk into match day 5, you know, we would like to just go ahead and make just 2 free transfers that we have. I got a strategy here to go ahead with this and keep that wild card for match day 6. And the reason we're doing this wild card for match day 6 is because by that time the qualification process would have been very clear for most of the teams. There would be some teams there who would be really fighting it all out to qualify for that second spot to go through. So basically those teams that are qualified there will definitely rest their stars, you know, especially those that have been guaranteed a top spot. You can expect some rotations there. So the thing is, it'll be risky to, you know, analyze it now. So it's better to let's see how match day 5 pans out, and then we'll trigger the wildcard for match day 6 for sure. So what will be our plans then for match day 4? So basically, if we look at it, we're going to get into our team now. And basically, the transfers that we're going to do is, we have decided on it already. So I'll just make the transfers now and let you guys know. So who are we getting out of our squad for this week? So, you know, we've spent a lot on this guy, and I think we have kind of had it with him already, and so we're just moving on with him because Juve is playing Chelsea in this match day. So it's just 9.2 million can be used for other stuff. So we'll be removing Chiesa and also Edson Alvarez. Good contribution, but this time, you know, why we decided to get him out as well is because we want to use this budget now of 14.9 and try to get 2, I would say, startable and even threat midfielders in terms of contributions for assists, ball recoveries, even goals, you know. And when we look back at the fixtures, the real dogfight, I would say, for this match day would be Dortmund versus Sporting Lisbon. Both are in with a qualification chance. Ajax have completely stormed past everyone in this group, you know, and Dortmund's defeats back to Ajax has basically opened up this group, made it wide open, but this I feel that Dortmund will finally just get through this sporting team, you know, and come through. You know, I may be proven wrong here, but I will really be thinking that Dortmund, we got the bank in on Dortmund there. So we already have Haaland there, you know, I'll just keep him there as the striker. As for the midfielder, well, you know, when it comes to Dortmund and when it comes to midfielders, I think we can't discount this guy, and that's why we're going to get him in here. Basically, it's Jude Bellingham. So we'll be bringing in Jude Bellingham into the midfield role, and that will leave us about 7.3 million to go. I was thinking, in fact, of going for Atalanta players, because Atalanta also is in with a fighting chance here to against Young Boys and when Villarreal play Man United. So the thing is, either we go for Atalanta or basically Inter will also want to solidify their ground here. So after thinking about it and with the budget I have on hand, basically I've decided to go for Inter. And the player that we're going to bring in from Inter, basically in the midfield role here, is, of course, their top scorer in the midfield, now Brozovic, with 6.8 million. And if you look at his stats, basically he had a fantastic match day 4 year against Sheriff, scored a goal, man of the match. He recovers a lot of balls and all this. So against Shakhtar, we're expecting, you know, a similar kind of production, or in fact, you know, even as close as that would be a fantastic way there for Brozovic. So basically, we're going to roll with Brozovic for our transfers for match day 5. So this is how our squad will be looking. And I'll just go ahead and use those transfers and confirm them. Yes, because it's 2 free transfers, so no hit on the points there as well. And I'll just go ahead and confirm, and this is how our squad will look. So, you know, guys, basically, I hope that, you know, you guys use these tips, or you have other tips as well, you know, please go ahead, you know, and share with us. You see, we are using guys like Musiala, we're still keeping him in the team because Bayern are storming in their group as well. They will start to use these guys, and he's definitely an attacking threat. Adeyemi, no doubt, you know, as an attacker, he's definitely in for it as well against Lille. So our squad is going to look like this, basically for match day 5, and I hope that basically you guys will get some, you know, tips from this, use it for your squad and all that. So guys, when we're going to select our captain, so basically when I'm thinking of captain, right, you know, of course we'll have to look at their dates, right, exactly when do these guys play. And when I think about it, right, you got 24th and 25th November, right? So you can either switch the captain on the day. So my first day captain, when I'm looking at the squad here, I'm thinking I'm either going to go with Adeyemi or maybe even Kimmich. But when I think about it even deeper now, let's go ahead and trigger the captain for Adeyemi as the first day captain. I'll just make him as captain there for the first day, and hopefully he brings in a barrage of points that I do not need to change the captain for the next 25th of November. But let's say, okay, let's just say in case this thing doesn't work out with Adeyemi on 24th, of course, then 25th, you see this fantastic fixtures. We have Dortmund fixtures. We have Inter also participating on 25th of November there. And of course, you know, when it comes to captain, you know, we must never discount this guy, Mo Salah, basically. But Mo Salah against FC Porto is definitely another captain option here for match for the second match. So it really depends how Adeyemi performs on 24th. And if he doesn't do well, then, you know, we'll probably just go to Salah or Haaland. So these are the two that I'm considering here. So there you have it, guys. Our squad, our transfers, and our captain strategies for match day 5. And I wish you guys all the luck for match day 5. All the best, guys. And now do like, share, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell, of course. You know, if you would like to have more videos of this content, let us know how you guys are doing, and we value every feedback. So thank you again, guys, for all your support. We really appreciate it so much. Have fun and have a blast in match day 5. See ya.